Now, are you surprised that you're still doing Shining interviews almost 35 years later?
Stanley Kubrick's work, you know, it goes on and on and on. He made so many movies that things like...
it has a life, yeah.
Yeah, and people come back to them. It's not surprising that it's 35 years on for The Shining, because it was so, at the time, it was so seminal. It made such a difference.
We are coming up on the 35th anniversary. You guys have just been starting to really get out there and go to a lot of conventions. What made you, you know, decide to start coming out now?
So I contacted him. He said, oh, you know, would you like to come over to America and do a convention? And we thought, well, you know, people aren't going to be that interested in us.
No, we didn't.
Yes. Mm. And he said, no, people would really like to know.
Yeah.
And we thought, oh.
It's only when you go over there and you see the number of people who are so clicked into the film that you think, my word, I can't believe people are so keen on the film. You know, it's impossible to imagine, because it was just one moment in our lives. But it seems to have been these people's reason for going on in their lives. It's become a really big thing for them. And that is very hard to...
It's very hard to describe how...
Imagine how that feels.
How have the fans been? What have been the fan interactions like for you?
Lovely. Incredible.
Absolutely.
Really incredible. I never thought that I'd meet people who had my image tattooed. And it's such... I mean, I keep going back to it with my sister. I keep saying to everyone, I say, they've got me tattooed on them. Such a compliment. It is such a compliment.
I saw you guys recently went back to the studio where they filmed the movie. What was that like for you?
Bittersweet.
Yes.
Really?
Sad,
because our bit of the movie has become Tesco's.
Yeah, because the sound studios that Shining was filmed on are now a car park.
When I went back, I felt as if I was being rubbed out, erased from history. I felt as if someone was taking my past away from me, because they had walked all over it and taken down the buildings, and it wasn't where I remembered any longer. And that was really, I was really sad about that, yeah.
Now, have you guys kept in contact with anyone else from the film over the years? Have you seen any of your co-stars?
A couple of cameramen, Doug Milsom, Jan Harlan, who was executive director.
And his brother-in-law.
Yeah, we've all stayed in contact with him. Mm. And also with Christiane Kubrick, his wife. We have kind of put tendrils out there towards people like Joe Turkel.
Oh, yeah.
Mm-hmm. We used to go shopping with, believe it or not.
He's a scream.
Because when you're making... You know, it takes a number of months to make a movie, so you become friends with the people who are on the movie. They become your family. It might only be that for sort of 9 or 10 months, you know, in a year, but they are you see them far more than you see your own real blood family.
Did you guys ever put the dresses on again, ever try and be the Grady Twins for Halloween?
In the UK, Halloween isn't such a big holiday. I think enough other people dress up as us.
Before I let you guys go, I have to ask you to say it. can I get you to say, come play with us, Brian?
Come play with us, Brian, forever and ever and ever.